Well, folks, sometimes I'm in the dark. You probably wonder about what. Well, let me tell you, sometimes it's baseball cards. This is Mark McGwire. I have two of the cards, but the difference is one of them has an error. And that error is missing a dot on INC. I actually have two cards and everything. And the reason why there's all these stickers, I'll tell you about that in a second. Just the regular Mark McGwire card is fine. But the one that's missing the dot, one person describes that as rare and has it listed for $499 right there. See? $499. Well, the thing that's perplexing to me is later on, somebody else has it listed for $14 and free shipping. Another person has $10 and free shipping. Then you got some of these other ones, $65, $95, all these different ones. So what's the true value? What's the market? That's where I become confused. But nevertheless, I guess you can always list the tie and take a little less. I'm not sure, but I usually stick in the middle and everything. So this Mark McGwire card, which I have two of them, I have one that's with and without, I'm going to sell them both together for not $499, a lot less than that, but not sure. But anyway, the search goes on. Who else got an ass like you? Who else throw it back like you? What else make them act like you? What else make them act like you? Yeah, I know you like my booty, 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 booty. Yeah, I know you like my. Ladies and gentlemen, we had all kinds of entertainment here. Gary said he was going to come and he's going to find a guitar. And when he found that guitar, he was going to serenade us all. So, Gary, let her rip.
I'm a little rusty, though.
There he goes. He's a little rusty. Okay.
I haven't played this in a while.
All right, everybody, hold your applause. Gonna sing together. Good man, good job. And here's the man who's gonna join him in song. No, not today. Not today. Okay. Looks like it's just you and me.
Okay,
get some vacation money in there. We need some vacation money. Well, folks, this is the auction here, and this was I had four units. One unit nobody wanted. In fact, it was just something to be burned. All old couches carried with mold and everything. Second one, Marvel bought, and she had a few little tools. And the third one, this is what I bought. I spent $5. Sometimes this is what's called a mercy buy. But I think we'll do. Obviously, we have this to burn, a broken mirror. I'm not sure what these are. Rice or children or something. I don't know. There's probably not any good. This is why I decided to go with it, because I'm not sure what this is. Might be mirrors, but we'll open it up and later on find out. And all the other little stuff, a couple of these dolls, some things I can sell. This is a good little balloon though, so obviously I got $5 worth. And this is a 10 by 10. So let's get to it. Here's two items that was found in that unit right there. Not to mention a balloon blower upper. I guess that's what it is. And those are just some of the finds. Of course, a lot of times there's a time to go shopping and everything. Sometimes you can find some good deals or not. And sometimes it's good to fish or shop in different areas that you normally don't go to. So let's pay close attention to this video, and you're going to see some of the places that we went. And how did we do? Well, you'll find out. Well, folks, I've heard a lot about Big Lots. I want to check it out, see if it's a good source to buy from. I don't know if any of you ever gone to it. I've heard a lot about it, but we'll find out. Let's go inside. Let's take a look and see what we find. So as we enter into the store, I approach it, and of course the door is going to open for me. Open Sesame, yeah, how about that? And right off the bat, I get a good overall view of things, and right off the bat, it doesn't seem like to be the kind of store that I expected it to be. 50% off, that's nice, big clearance. And small little packages, ideal for possibly resale. But I'm not sure, I haven't looked at it quite like this. We'll keep looking. When I first entered the store, I saw those signs that said 80%, 90%. And I really wasn't sure what to make of it. Turns out when I talked to the manager, whatever price they have on there, if it's like $5, that 90% applies to that. So that seems like a pretty good deal,
like
overall.
A regular store to me.
But I found this store to be a whole lot similar to Dirt Cheap, but a much better condition, as you can tell. And the shelves weren't over. I honestly expected to find like 100 or 200 of one item or 300 Big Lots. But that's not actually how it works. You can see there are a lot of empty shelves there, and apparently this was sales that actually took place that actually emptied the shelves pretty quickly. And sometimes it's good to get an idea of what has been selling. And when you get something that's reasonably priced and they have it marked down, it makes it very desirable to be able to purchase it for resale. But all in all, I looked at a lot of them and the prices were not extremely good for me. But I know it's like anything. You have to realize that you have to be there at the times where the specials are. But sometimes just find things that you know that somebody wants, that somebody's been selling, and it moves quick. Now, I ended up buying something in this store. I ended up buying, and of course, you'll see that at the end of it. I actually bought two video games, I think.
An etch and
I could have
sketch.
Bought more, but I checked the other two. Or maybe I just bought one. I checked it online and found out that that one sold, you know, like three times what I was paying for. The other one was just almost twice, and I said, that's not so desirable for me. I like to get triple my money if I can, just for the simple reason that not everything sells right away. Of course, when I look at some of these items, as I said before, it looks like they just have a few. And initially, I'm a little disappointed because I thought it would be more like a whole bunch. But here's a problem. When they put $10 on a package and $5, most of the people, that's what they're going to want to pay. So it's hard to sell that online unless it gets to have some sort of age. And those were not particularly old. In fact, I even noticed that even the clothing, the beverages, some of the stuff that you would get in a grocery store. And as I said before, I really wasn't checking the prices for as a consumer, but for resale. And of course, cornflakes is nothing I can sell, but obviously it's something I can eat because everybody knows Frosted Flakes are great. Okay, so much for that. And as well as the little peanuts and other little items there. But the variety is nice, but as I said before, when you're shopping to buy things for resale, those become, you look at things on a totally different level there. And so as a consumer, it's different. But when you're a buyer, it's a whole different animal, as they say.
So let's continue to look and let's see what else we can find. And maybe then we'll make a decision. Sometimes I thought I was in Walmart.
It's
a remarkably
inflate the prices so that it makes like that type of store. Money.
So it's interesting. It's good, but it's not what I thought to be. It looks more like an Ollie store that hasn't been stocked. So coming up is I'll show you what I actually bought or what I evaluated.
Okay, here's three of them that I looked at, and I've decided that these are on the same price line, but this is the one that I want because it's worth more. $15. Okay, let's return to Doc. Let's return to Dirt Cheap. Doc returned the Dirt Cheap. Last time we did real good on it, well, and we filmed that episode, and we're going to find out how we can do here. It's a shopping day. Let's find out what we got.
This initially caught my eye, 40% off with different food items, but you know, that's fine if you just want them for yourself. But as I went farther down, I noticed that there were obviously always a lot of clothes, but they had a lot of merchandise and once again, 40%. That's usually not really a good deal. Usually like you get 70, 80, 90%. But by that time, they were pretty well beaten up. This stuff wasn't bad, but even at 40%, it was not cheap enough for me to spend the extra money for resale. I think I could have done better, so I didn't buy anything at this point. And overall, the boxes were in good shape, but if you look at some of the prices, you know, like this one, it said $9.99. Well, that's basically gonna be $5. So that's not a bad price. And this one, of course, there would be about $6, that'd be $8, so. A lot of different Batmans. In fact, the Batmans were good. But something else was coming up special too. And in fact, this is it.
This sounds interesting, but it's basically, it says 39, but by the time you take off 40%, that's $12. Makes it 26, 27. That might be too much for that. But I'm gonna get this because it's a unique Batman. It's gonna cost me, it's $9.99, but it's gonna cost me $5. Some more of the items there.
Usually you don't have such a nice selection as this, with all the different cars, all from the different same company and everything, which would be a good find if
you're
trying
to
capitalize on something. Barbie dolls, those were good. These toys here were very interesting.
Black,
Black Panther still
Funko
popular.
Pop and T-shirt.
So they're like $29.99 at 40%.
That's only less.
What is that? $8 less.
$14.
$10 less. So it'd be $18. Still a little on the high side for me. So there's more to see, and more to buy.
Big Legos. Those
the Legos is always real popular. I always found that to be the case.
Like this one, you get the whole team for $50. This is interesting. 40% off. Have the same item. I paid $10 for it. Unfortunately, this one's selling for $36. Or fortunately, selling or not selling. Anyway, Baby Yoda. Here's an example of Funko Pops. This one's aren't so bad. The problem is they tend to be beat up here. And this one, when they stick labels on this thing, they don't know what they're doing, but they're ruining it. and making it hard to
purchase for resale. Well, I hope you're a little shopping thing. We usually see the pops at the GameStop, but we saw them there. Usually they're beat up bad, but it's so bad. Folks, this is just two of the stops.
Rainbow High.
We're going to go to another stop. It's different from this one. Check it out.
Well, folks, I don't know if that looks backwards to you. But if it does, it's the camera. But anyway, let me just show you what I got. Really, the dirt cheap experience wasn't that good. They didn't have anything. Everything was 40%, and there was nothing, no variation. But the merchandise was nice. The Funko Pops were okay, but again, they were really overpriced. But I got this Batman because I thought the Batman was unique. I mentioned I was going to. And I got this one because, once again, it's a very nice-looking Mandalorian. And I thought maybe Star Wars will come back. Okay, folks, I'm going to try something new, something different, something I hadn't originally thought about doing. It's going to the Arch. It's primarily, they sell clothes, and that's not really what I want to buy to resell. But then someone told me they had other stuff, and they showed me an example of what they bought, and it was real cheap. So I'm going to try that, like, instead of the Goodwill. So let's see what the Arch looks like inside. Okay.
Still in final, no refund, no public restroom. Hello. I had my eye on this one. I thought it was unique, but after I checked it, I found out that little hand sewing machine is not that profitable. The price wasn't quite good enough anyway. Common glassware. I'm amazed at how they stores do that. Them and shoes. My Goodwills. But people do buy glassware. I've noticed that at Becky's Barn, seeing them coming out with items. So all the different merchandise that you have, and even games, board top games. But I guess, as I said before, they were already all open. They were very common. And I had interest in one of them, but I decided not to buy it. And this is the one. Here I'm looking for movies that were unopened, but mostly looking for PlayStation games. That's always, but as I said, they're always hard to find, but they do sell quick. And books, there's always plenty of books available. Unless you got an autographed book by a celebrity, it's really just not overall that special.
It's like a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now let's take a quick
room look
at the
Becky's Barn. Room 26 has changed. We still got the tub. A lot of new things. Entire booth, 20% off. Take a look at some of these gems. Folks, you can't wait much longer. Don't walk, run. Come and get these sales here at Becky's Barn. Yeah. As I guarantee you, it will make you happy. You will look more like this than this. If you play your cards right, you never know who you're going to meet. You never know.